第一次来景颇族地区是1991年，也是第一次来中国啊，然后马上就来到德宏，做那个宰牧研究做了很多年了啊。说我是不小心出生在河南的景颇人，我觉得这没有什么夸张的，我哪里都可以做一个开心的人，但对我来说，景颇山，是最有家的感觉。时间过得真快，有时想起来，居然已经过了快25年了。我叫乐安东，景颇族的名字叫葛古甘邦，乐家的大儿子。
5 years ago, Anton Lustig, a Dutch national, and his Chinese wife, Li Yang, established the Prop Roots public program, integrating traditional Jingpo culture with Zewa language and art education. Children are the main focus. The Prop Roots Center is housed in a bamboo building on the highest point in the village. The structure incorporates both the Jingpo architectural style and some modern design elements. Villagers here usually live on the grain they grow themselves. They raise poultry for their own consumption and buy vegetables from the public market once every 5 days, several kilometers away. Anton totally lacks farming experience. When he was told a kernel can grow into a big tree, he sowed seeds around his house as part of a bet. Unfortunately, days of heavy rain ruined almost all his hard work, leaving just some pumpkins and lentils. The longer Anton lives in the village, the better he understands the old saying, farmers are at the mercy of the elements. Today is market day. Villagers come from far and wide to engage in trade.
我管的钱都是买菜的钱，我不管大钱啊。我喜欢去街子，那个老能碰到熟人，可以聊聊天，也可以学一点东西嘛。怎么砍价？我砍得不够厉害。总的来说，可能买的比别人还是比别人贵一点啊。
讲韩话呀？
啊，我讲
的。讲你们外国话，我们听不懂啊。
啊，对，没关系。那个荷兰属于欧洲啊。
欧洲。
啊，那边讲荷兰语啊。
荷兰语。中国发达是外国发达，哪个国家发达？
怎么说呢？都不一样啊。
不一样。我们老家是河南。
河南啊，
河南，
哎，我跟我们一样啊，哎对，
我是中国河南，
中国河南，对。 经常有人问我老家在哪儿，我就说，哎，老家在河南。一般听众河南还挺惊讶，河南人怎么长这样了啊？不是河南省，是欧洲，是欧洲一个国家叫荷兰。
Anton enjoys living in the mountains.He is very familiar with the street market, which is filled with a dazzling array of foods and seasonings such as lime, fishy smell herb, sour bamboo roots, and chili, which are indispensable in Jingpo cuisine. They're all used in creating different tastes.Most vendors here know Anton. Sometimes they offer a discount or give him a handful of vegetables for free. Anton enjoys his life here without a supermarket, cheese, or hamburgers. He isn't a fussy eater. He loves to eat a 7 yuan bowl of rice noodles available on the street. The soup stewed with chicken and pork tastes so delicious.Anton even loves a local specialty known as sapay, prepared with minced raw beef.
我认为世界上最好吃的就是景颇菜，各种各样的葱菜，加一些豆豉、山姜那些特别香的。荷兰人自己不会做饭，我觉得，热餐嘛，就是那个煮的土豆没有味道，蔬菜
煮得很烂的，没有味道。然后，那个确实不怎么好吃。我来一个景颇族的。
Villages in Xishan Township are scattered on the mountain slopes. Each community is small, containing no more than 6 households. In the early morning, the adults go to work in the cornfields, and the children are left behind to look after themselves. For villagers, they have to survive on a lot of outdoor skills. When they're hungry, they turn to the mountainside for wild fruits and vegetables. They learn to cut firewood as toddlers, and no one thinks it's dangerous to wield a knife at such a young age. In this part of the world, children are used to running through the mountains and living on instinct.
Shigaofen, it's a strange thing. I'll put a little bit in the cup. Look, let's put a little bit of water. How will it be?
It's not easy to keep children here sitting for a 45-minute lesson. So Prop Roots usually organizes activities that involve children doing something, such as making tree leaf rubbings. It's only at this point that the children will sit down and focus.
一个误导就是老号召孩子们走出大山，刻苦学习才有出路。走出大山的意思就是告诉孩子你的家乡不好。刻苦读书似乎是唯一的出路，那就是告诉他，如果你不适合考试，那你就一无是处，这是非常不好的一个概念。很多的艺术课上面都尽量用景颇山里现成的材料，孩子们就会发现说，哦，原来艺术可以是我们身边就有的，帮孩子找回本来就应该有的自信，找回非常良好的自我感觉。
所以学习想要和别人一模一样，因为你本来就是不一样的。我们每个人都要做自己，做一个最好看的叶子。
让我讲个好，懂吗？你共懂吗？叫龙表。表家咧，那个木匠些。
Anton is a linguist. His field of study is the Zewa language. In the past 20 years, he has devoted himself to writing a 1,700-page book, a grammar and dictionary of Zewa, in 2 volumes. It is the first book to introduce the language in detail. Right now, Anton is choosing a story for a Prop Roots puppet show.The story is about a group of wily rabbits. It's interesting, but lacks a hook. Anton revises the story many times. Jingpo youth share the same experiences growing up. No matter where their dreams may take them,The home will always be their home. People working in the fields are not picky about their dress, so Anton feels at ease.He hasn't found a pair of slippers big enough for him in the market, so he has to wear smaller ones. He doesn't have a problem with this.
行吗？
你这裤子行，哎呀，你这还有一个破洞呢，这不行。见人不能穿有破洞衣服，快去换去。
安东这个人挺有意思的，生活上他有好多的小细节，非常的不讲究。袜子上有个破洞。然后画画的那个画画的时候的衣服上面全是颜料，他不觉得有什么问题，直接穿着有颜料的衣服就出门了。反正觉得好像只在乎他认为很重要的事情。 每次进城要见人去谈事情的时候就有麻烦了。然后我就试图让他理解什么场合要穿什么衣服，
穿什么皮鞋，好像很重要，各种讲究，这些我不懂，我也不需要懂，对不对？
最后也听不下去了，他说：“
哎，人类真麻烦，哎，有那么多讲究。”
Wiley Rabbits is far from being good enough, and Anton has been trying to improve it for days. He invites some Jingpo kids to help him in the process. The children's questions offer Anton hints.The folktale, passed down orally through the generations, has lost its popularity. Are there people in the village who can answer such questions?
These children are Jingpo Zhu's hope. Those lost traditions, they can find a new way to find and transmit them.
Anton Lustig, a PhD student in Sino-Tibetan language from Leiden University, first came to China in 1991. He went to live in a Jingpo village on the China-Myanmar border in Yunnan province. He was the first European the villagers had ever seen up close. During the Jingpo carnival, Anton was like a mascot. He was invited by many villages in their celebrations.Having a photo taken with him was popular.
这里的人肯定热情的多呀，你吃了没有啊？你给你倒点水，倒点茶。印象最深的那就是第一次跳舞蹈，是真的就是跳了两天连一夜，也没睡觉，晚上围着篝火接着跳，大家都跳得特别开心。
For several days, Anton went from house to house, but had little luck. He decided to visit Pei Dang, a knowledgeable old man in the village.
How many gong dong? Oh, you,
kai, liang bao, liang bao, mi biao, guan guan.
As an orally transmitted language, Zehua has no written records available. Many legends are known only by the elderly.In the past few decades, Anton spoke with villagers going door to door. He invited them to identify the meanings of the Latin-based Zehua words to be included in his dictionary. A warm-hearted old lady explained to him the weaving tools that Jingpo women used in the past.
I cut the Zehua words and the hard skin off.进入了很神秘的世界，就像一个人在建一个巨大的宫殿一样，就每天做一点点，盼着完成那一天。
Compiling volumes, the dictionary has been published, but Anton finds it means another start.
我太轴吧，一定得做完。我一开始，选择的研究方法也不是那种很快就能做完的。这部书虽然是给语言学家写的，但是我在一页就写了，我把它献给所有热情能干的景颇族，是他们创造了这个神奇的语言和文化。昂啊哈哦，
Around the 15th day of the first lunar month every year, people celebrate their biggest festival, the Munao Singing Festival, to worship the sun god. Before the ceremony, the Dongsa, or village priest, chants spells to dispel evil. The leaders of the singing team wear crowns made from a hornbill's head and decorated with boar tusks, which are wrapped in red or green silk robes. Jingpo villages still follow a traditional way of worshiping. On the big day, Jingpo villagers, dressed in traditional garb, gather at the venue. The festival lasts for 3 days and three nights.
Welcome to China. Hey, 老外也来跳啊。其实他们还没有出生的时候，我已经在这跳木挠了。
Since Anton is European, white and has blonde hair, he's always the focus of attention. The Mu Nao Festival means a gala where people sing and dance.Every time, the gala attracts up to 1,000 to 10,000 participants. Ancestors of the Jingpo people evolved from the ancient Dichang tribe living on the eastern edge of the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau. Forced out by repeated wars, they moved southward to the tropical jungles of southwest China.Over the centuries, the Jingpo people have celebrated this way, led by experienced team leaders. Each team has numerous people dancing in a long queue, winding its way forward and moving to the beat. The line is symbolic of the convoluted route the ancestors of the Jingpo people took to get here.
我27岁来中国，没想到，最后还定居在中国。我们不会离开这儿的，跟当地社会、跟当地人这么好的联系，对更多神奇的事情啊。
In 2005, Anton started to teach Dutch at the Beijing Foreign Studies University. While there, he took up painting, a hobby he had put aside for more than 10 years during his research on the Zewa language.After 4 years of teaching in Beijing, he and his wife, Li Yang, chose to settle down in Dahong. With a bank loan, they set up the Prop Root Center.
在中国，总的来说，大家追求安全感，就是说什么东西给人安全感，那肯定是，金钱吧，物质，地位越高越踏实，因为这个竞争可以说其实是竞争很激烈的社会。
这一辈子里边有的是比安全感重要的多的事情。
什么事情得自己判断，我们就做的我们自己觉得是对的。
Anton Lustig was born into an ordinary Dutch family in Dordrecht in 1964. His father was an emergency worker, his mother a nurse.Anton showed his unusual ability in painting as a child. When he wasn't doing art, Anton was mostly a loner. He was diagnosed with autism. Often he would shut himself in his room to draw. His parents demanded he cut his hair, which annoyed him a great deal.
反正画画的时候，你就会特别注意一些自己的一些灵感，更容易注意到自己的都是脑子里想的一些东西。
At the age of 20, Anton's condition worsened. He was sent to a psychological rehab center to receive special therapy for autism.This lasted until his mother became critically ill.
你就好好 照顾妈妈，就是不要胡思乱想，我一定要给她看，有很多想做的事情，很快就可以离开那个地方，我就是为了让她相信我是没问题的。
When Anton prepared to return to the university campus, he was approaching 30. Good thing is he had no regrets. The time he spent helped him understand he needed to do something he liked.
我觉得孩子们最需要的就是被尊重、被肯定、被在乎。有时候你去一个地方，你计划再回来，也许最后一辈子都没有再回来，可是孩子就等在那里了。然后你跟他的无意中做出好多好多的承诺，我要跟你一直联系，建立的非常浓厚强烈的私人关系，如果突然断了，这种是二次伤害，是更严重的。所以这次咱们不说一样的话了，不是说老说不怪他，那不还是催人家，对吧？不是那意思，你告诉他我又你回信了，是不是？其实就是真的是这样的行为要想清楚再去做，你还是需要不是一个暑假寒假的长期的陪伴着他们。
啊，阿刚，没水了。
啊，等孩子，等孩子要来呢，我去看水塔有没有啊？
对，太阳能。
对，关键太阳能被爆了。
哎呀。
安东，那进太阳能的口都露出来了，咱赶紧修吧。
Since Anton has filled out his story about the wily rabbit from an old villager, the puppet show can begin at once.Dozens of children from nearby villages will come for the show. The water stopping at this moment is really troublesome. Anton thought it would be easy to repair it himself. If it doesn't work, they may end up collecting rainwater to tide them over. The situation seems much worse than previously thought. The Prop Root Center runs short of water.When making props for the puppet show, an accident occurs. Will Anton and his neighbors be able to make it through the difficulty?
马东大哥受伤了，很严重。
For the next part of Summer of Life.